after the service, daddy, daddy was going home and he said, Ima, I'm not falling in love with you. I said, daddy, I received. And he laid it on my head and I left home. And on Saturday, in the morning, I came here for cleaning up to arrange the canopy. And after the arrangement of the canopy, I was going home by 10 a.m. to the house. And I received a strange call. I said, who is on the line? He said, are you Apostle Ima? I said, yes, I'm Apostle Ima. He said, please, can you come and do my white paper to two twins? Can you come and do the naming at home? I said, don't you have a church? But for security reasons, it's a big church. But for security reasons, I'm not going to call the name of the church. Hallelujah. Amen. It's a big church. You call the name of the church. All the pastors disappointed me.
Wow.
He said, somebody gave me my number that they have heard about me. That I should come and do the thing. So I said, there's no problem. I said, I will come. I said, the man said, I hope you will come. The father of the twins said, I hope you will come. I said, I will come. I went home, I dressed up. From there, I lay down, I prayed. I said, God, this is the first time I'm doing naming in my life. I've not gone for naming before. Apart from the time that he sent me as a priest for naming. I just went. I said, God, let the God of my father, because people are coming for that naming very, very well. And it's a big church. He invited people. And I said, let the God of my father go with me. I prayed and I laid my hand upon my head. And I carried the magazine. I placed it on my head. And I said, as I go, let the wisdom of God come upon me. And the power flowed, the people give their life to Christ. And I went. As I reached them, they came and beat me. And I went. They went on me. People were much in that place. And they called me up. I opened one scripture. I preached for 45 minutes. I said, you didn't mean I preached like this. After I finished, I hold the children. I said, let the God of my father. I connect to the God of my father. And I named the children. I did everything. After finishing, I called everybody one by one. I began to give them prophetic. I said, let the God of my father. I gave them prophetic. And after I finished, power this a woman. A woman from the preacher that is not the name of the church. Power hit her on the hand. She fell down. And she said, where am I coming from? I said, I'm coming from Pastor Agbo's church. He said, I know Pastor Agbo, man. You see that? You see that stubborn man?
The devil is on fire
today. You see that man? I came to open him in his ministry. I said, God is using my dream. I'm connected to him. And they bless me and they say, I will go far.
Amen.
And the mother of the two twins collected my number. And a lady went away. He said, my friend said, I should give her my number.
Wow.
That she's valid for 8 years. That I'm calling to the house to come and pray for the woman.
And daddy declared that that person is being delivered. So I give God the glory that I was delivered that day in the name of Jesus.
Looking for money, I said, oh, come, since we're here, attend this prayer before you go. So he now attended a meeting. So that he also prophesied that there's someone that had a chest pain. So he now laid hand on him. He came out and he laid hand on him. So when the boy went back, now he called me on Sunday that I should please testify on behalf of him that since he has gone to the school, that he has been here. The head is bigger than my body. So that he also prophesied and laid hand on me. Now I'm free as air in my body. I feel like that is whatever it comes, even if you don't want to pass where I stand, things happen in my life.
Tell us your name and go straight to the testing.
Praise the Lord. My name is Ike, my sister. And when I came here, before on the
don't you know me already? My life has not remained the same before the existed this place. Well, no one ever touched my heart the way I held it here at the change room. And the most important part of it is that this is my first testimony in my whole life. Not because God had not been faithful, but because I was living in immorality. So I couldn't come out. The guilt would not allow me to come out to say how faithful God has been to me. Right from when I was born till now, it has been from one mystery to another. If you look at my forehead, down to my neck, it has always been accident. I schooled in Jos for 3 years. I escaped crisis 3 times. Not because I was righteous, but I felt God was keeping me for a purpose. And that was the reason why I came here and I heard the word. I've been restless since November last year. I didn't know that if God could arrest me, every situation in my family would change. That is what is happening now. Each time I hear the word here, I go home and we do devotions with that same word I hear, the word of God. I preach it to them and we live on that word throughout the day. And right now we are living in peace in our family. All because of the blessed God's children. All because I surrender all to God, the spirit and the truth. Because I did not come here because I needed a husband. I needed the word of God that will fill my soul. I am here now. I don't even talk of food. I look more fresher than before. Tuesday, I bought some goods that I'm selling and have not sold for up to a week, not even one. And after sharing with him, he prayed over the goods and he told me my daughter go and sell. Immediately I stepped outside, I sold. Up to today, I'm still selling and I'm still making money.